So and the other thing that I would do is I would see my DMs. I would go into my DMs, man. Who the fuck will be messaging me? How does a creep sound like? Can you guys do me a favor? Can you guys go to your other folder and read some right now? అందరికి నమస్కారం, వెల్కమ్ టు బేకార్ ముచ్చట్లు. ఈరోజు మన టాపిక్, వాట్ వుడ్ యు డూ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ వాట్ ద ఫక్ ఐ ఫర్గాట్ ద టాపిక్ ఓకే వాట్ వుడ్ యు డూ ఇఫ్ యు వోక్ అప్ యాజ్ ది ఆపోజిట్ జెండర్. ఓకే, బేసిక్గా పొద్దున లేవంగానే మీరు మీ ఆపోజిట్ జెండర్ లాగా ఉంటే ఏం చేస్తారు? అండ్ మళ్ళీ దీన్ని పొలిటికల్గా ఓన్లీ అబ్బాయిలు అమ్మాయిలేనా, ట్రాన్స్జెండర్స్ లేరా, వీళ్ళు లేరా అని అట్లా అనకండి. జస్ట్ హైపోథెటికల్గా ఇఫ్ యు guy works up as a woman and a woman works up as a guy. So let's get started. And ee roju mana panel lo unnadi the smart, the confident bookstagram ka naya misal Vishakha Raghav aka Wishing Sky, and the others are Jesse and Shruti. So okay, since you are the guest who comes very rarely, that's why the intro was like that. And these are my friends who come regularly, so I take them for granted. Yeah, they can understand.
I want to unmute my mic and I want to say, do you mean that I'm not your friend?
No. They are regular friends and you come very rarely, right? So that's why I need to give you the I need to give you the hype for the audience. ఓకే, బిఫోర్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఎల్స్, నేనే గనక అమ్మాయిగా లేస్తే ఐ వుడెంట్ సే దట్ ఐ వుడ్ బి స్కేర్డ్ అండ్ స్టఫ్ లైక్ దట్. ఆఫ్టర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఐ వుడ్ గో చెక్ మై సెల్ఫ్ అవుట్, యునో. ఈవెన్ దో ఐ ఆమ్ సడన్లీ చేంజ్ ఇన్ టు అన్ ఆపోజిట్ జెండర్, మై బ్రెయిన్ ఇస్ స్టిల్ ఎ మ్యాన్స్ బ్రెయిన్, రైట్? సో యాజ్ ఎ మ్యాన్ ఐ వుడ్ గో చెక్ మై సెల్ఫ్ అవుట్ వెదర్ ఐ మీన్ ఎ షేప్ ఆర్ నాట్. సో డూ ఐ లుక్ గుడ్, స్టఫ్ లైక్ దట్. దట్ వుడ్ బి ద వెరీ ఫస్ట్ థింగ్ దట్ ఐ వుడ్ డూ. What would you guys do? The very first thing. Who wants to go next? Jesse? I want to hear from you. Jesse,
yeah,
is stuck.
I don't know, man. I mean, I'll be shocked. I would be shocked for sure. I mean, once I come out of that shock stage, yeah, I'll go to my parents. I'll just get dressed up and I'll go to my parents and I'll just say, I'm your daughter-in-law. Your son married me. I was here for the whole night. He just went out. He's not coming and I'm worried. So I'll watch them freak out.
You'll watch them freak out. See, what if your family and everyone were okay? Everyone were okay, okay? Let's hypothetical situation. You change into an opposite gender. It's a parallel world. Everything was okay, cool. So what would you do then? But you only the one person who knows that you are a guy who changed into a woman. So what would you do?
Yeah, I mean, lots of things, right? I mean, basically, I'll start with, you know, calling up my friends and teasing them.
Yeah, yeah, that's actually a great identity. That's actually a great idea, yeah.
Yeah, I'll check my hair, you know. I mean, the gender is changed. I mean, I hope the
hair, yeah.
I don't know. Maybe I'll go travel in a public bus or see how it actually is for women actually in public transport and all stuff. Maybe I'd go for outing in the night to see how it actually works for women.
That's it. Too much of stuff for the first day when you figured out that you're a woman, man. That's too much.
For the first day, let's say, I mean, I might try, you know, wearing a sari or something and...
I can't figure out shit about sari. You know, my girlfriend, this fucking pod reminded me of my ex so much. No, I regretted it later, but you know, my ex tried to wear a sari and she couldn't figure out shit, you know. And she's a fashion designer. Of course, she's a fashion designer from here. So sari is not an easy thing, man. That's very tough. I think I would go with a t-shirt and a jeans, or maybe the most cliche would be a chudidar, maybe. Will I be judged if I say the colors too right now?
No. You might get judged.
What color?
Probably you should wear pink.
No, pink. I hate pink. So you need to remember that I might be a woman, but I still have a man's brain. So
black or white?
Yeah, I would. I always look up to the women who wear this white leggings and white chudidar. I don't know, and a red chunni. I go to them and wearing all black. Yeah, that also looks good. I don't know whether it suits me or not, but yeah, I would go for that if I have to wear a woman's clothes. That would be my choice. We will get it. We'll get back to it. Let's go to Wishing Sky.
I mean, the first thing what I would do is if I realize like I got up and I look myself in the mirror or whatever, and I understand that, okay, I'm a guy now. So I'll have the privilege of being standing up.
I asked my colleagues the same question, especially women. Everyone said the same. I would enjoy the privilege of peeing while I am standing. I mean, itna badi baat kya hai yaar usme?
Bahut badi baat hai. It's just because you guys can do it. It's not a big thing for you. But going to washroom in public places, that becomes so easy, so convenient. So that'll come handy. No pun intended.
Yeah. Yeah, but then again, yeah, I remember the fights we had with my ex to lift the toilet seat up, you know, so it might be a big deal for you guys. Yeah, yeah, that's a great, great idea. Yeah. And what about you, Shruti?
Maybe I'll just sleep back. I would think it's still a dream. But after I come to the senses, I would exactly do the same thing what Vishakar said. I would enjoy the privilege of being outside, especially in public. I know it's something. Something weird, but yeah. Apart from that, maybe I'll see myself how I look in the mirror. Then I would check my voice because, like,
oh yeah,
being a male, you have a different voice. I'll see how I'm going to sound, how rough I'm going to sound.
I didn't even realize that thing, man. How would I sound if I was a female? Damn.
And maybe the next thing, maybe I would go shirtless somewhere and feel.
Yeah. See, the thing is, I realized it, that woman doesn't have a physical freedom, but they have emotional freedom. Guys have physical freedom, but we don't have the emotional freedom. You know, you can, as you guys said, you as a guy, I can pee outside. That's a very okay thing, but as a woman, you can't even scratch, or you can't even sit the way you want. You can't do the things which we take for very granted. You know, you can't smoke outside. You will be judged for very certain things. I think, other side, the emotional freedom that I get as a woman, man, I could express the shit out of myself. As a guy, I can't do that. You know, you can't complain about the shit that is around you. And I would enjoy that privilege, the emotional freedom that I have.
And another thing I would like to add to Ajay's point is, like, if you are a girl and you are expressing yourself, then 100 people will listen to you. But if you are a guy and you are expressing yourself, maybe a couple of them are going to listen.
They listen and they don't give a fuck. And a woman, they listen and they might give you a fuck. Okay,
they will.
So, and the other thing that I would do is I would see my DMs. I would go into my DMs, man. Who the fuck will be messaging me? How does a creep sound like? Can you guys do me a favor? Can you guys go to your other folder and read some right now? try, Shruti. Then others folder, Kelly, what were the messages? You know, what do they send you? Did you guys get any dick pics or something like that?
I've never.
Okay, let's hope after this pod.
No.
Yeah, you will start getting some, Megan.
Okay, what are the messages that you get then?
I mostly get about, give me free books. How do I start reading? Please give me your books.
No, that's right now. But since BTech, that's not what...
Yeah, earlier, hi, dear. Okay. So I don't like the sound of deer. I don't know if Shruti agrees with me or not, but it sounds very, very cliche and very.
You're not that close to me. Why are you calling me deer? Something like that. Yeah.
Unknown strangers calling you like that.
Yeah.
They are not writing a letter to a you know, commissioner of municipality or something. Dear like that. Yeah, it always feels awkward.
But Jesse, correction, you don't write a letter for the commissioner saying, dear sir. You need to write as respected sir.
Respected sir, yeah.
So,
half mark deducted, right. Yeah.
What do you get, Shruti?
Yeah, the same thing probably. Like, hi, hello. These are the first things. Only when you try to respond to them, then it goes more worse. So you just try to avoid in the initial stage, then it will be just hi, hello. It wouldn't be more creepier.
Okay. So you yeah, have you guys ever responded or something like that?
I've responded to people who give a trail of messages. Okay. So there are two kinds of stalkers. First ones are who are okay and normal. They give you one or two messages and then they stop if you're not replying.
Mm-hmm.
But the second ones, they are more dangerous and they keep sending you messages till you reply.
Yeah.
So, hello, hi, how are you? Where are you? Are you there? ? Emojis. So that keeps coming. So mm-hmm. that is when I get irritated and I have to ask, do I know you? So that is the only response that I give. And that is when they actually stop.
Yeah.
So that works.
Okay. As guys, we won't get a lot of DMs at all. So one time, even though if we get a DM, we would be thinking like some guy is messing with us as a girl.
Angel Priya.
Yeah, I mean, if we get Angel Priya, exactly.
Yeah, Angel Priya. Oh my God. The next thing that I would go for is I would enjoy the free food and drinks that I get. It's not like, you know, women don't want to pay or they will pay, you know. But as a man, there is a pressure. If you are on a dates or something like that, most of the time, there is a pressure on the guy to pay. You need to pay. For example, when I was in a relationship, you know, my woman wanted to be very independent. We share. So we went to coffee shop or something. So she ordered some dessert. We were together, and she ordered something and she's taking her card out, and even I was also taking my card out, and we kept both our cards at the same time, and we looked at him, and the guy was like, whom I have to take, and it's your choice, and then he took my card. But my woman was like, why did you take his card? You can take my card, it was my order. Yeah. And he then said, it's bro code, ma'am. So, you know, even though my woman wanted to pay, there's this pressure for the guys to go, no, I'll pay. So I would enjoy those free food and drinks that I have, that I would get.
Yeah, it doesn't happen with everyone every time, but yeah, it happens. If you are in a relationship or, you know, just
if you are go, I mean, in friends ka to pata nahi, friends hote hai yaar. So they will be like, tu kharid le vaisa. But if I don't pay, she might think that he's not taking the charge. If I split it into half, will I be, I mean, I'll be the feminist or like, no, there are a million things that would be going around. So to ignore all of this, no, men,
they just pay. Yeah,
they just pay. So yeah, that I would enjoy.
So reality check, do you guys like paying or are you just doing it because it is bound by society that it would look good if you do it? So what is the real deal there?
That's actually a good question though. In my view, we would appreciate if you want to share the pay bill, you know, you ate, I ate, and I'm talking about the date situation. We don't know whether we'll meet again or not. We would appreciate it and we won't judge you even if you won't pay. And I expect the same from you. If I ask you to pay half of it, please don't judge me. That I would hope from you, but I don't know whether it's possible or not. As if I turn into a woman, I'm going into a date, I would, since I have the experience, I would pay half of it so that I don't, you know, owe to you. Sorry. So yeah, that's how I think. And what is the you guys think?
I think on the dates, I have paid. It's not like that I have not paid. Yes, I have paid, but I've never been on those kind of dates that you just meet once and then after that you're not meeting. So I've not been on those dates. But normally, like if boyfriend, girlfriends, if they are going outside, then I have paid. Only once it happened that I have been outside, but I have not paid. That was when six of us, we went out, school friends. We met after like 4-5 years. And we were two girls and four guys. So they paid the bill. They divided among themselves. And when I asked them that, what is my share, please let me know. Then they were like, you don't have to pay. We are not letting you girls pay.
Obviously.
That is when I was like, okay, this thing also happens. So that was the first time that a guy told me that, no, you don't have to pay. So pehli baar main free ka khana khaya tha usse.
Wo usse pehle kabhi nahi tha? Aur uske baad?
Nahi, almost nahi. Because we used to keep tab of who is like first time you pay, second time I'm paying, like that. So
we always
used to alternate between the payments.
Yeah. Gotcha. Friends, it's friends, right? Yeah. So Jesse, have you ever been on a date?
Yeah, I haven't been on a date so far. If I become a woman, so I'll do one thing. I'll find a lesbian woman and I'll be in a relationship and I can tell people about it. Like I have a girlfriend now.
Oh.
That's the thing I can do if I become a woman. I don't know if I can do it right now.
I've read this some bad joke. It's a filthy joke. If I turn into a woman, that joke goes like this. If I turn into a woman, I go to my friends and fuck them. Because if I don't do that, they will die virgin. So...
actually put up a photo of mine in online dating apps actually to see how many right swipes I would get.
I actually, that's the same reason why I don't have a dating profile. I don't install Tinder and stuff, because in the back of my mind, what if I won't get any likes? No, I'd be like, what the fuck, man? I'll lose my confidence. It's like walking into a gay club and nobody is hitting on you. So I don't want that. So that's why you might say that you should be okay with the rejections and stuff like that. But, I don't want that diversion to think, why is no one liking that picture? And I don't want to get addicted to that stuff. So, yeah, that's actually scary. Do you girls have the same things if you don't get any right swipes or not? You are getting DMs, man. Of course, you will get some right swipes easily. Yeah,
getting the DMs from creeps like the handsome people they want to meet. Like,
what will they know if the creep is right swiping in a Tinder profile? So, yeah, that's what I'm talking. And if I turn into a girl, I would see who is my BFF. Who is my soul sister? Yeah, sure. No, the girls have such things. My best friends forever. My entry to the women's world are only my girlfriends who have been there and my sister. So I'm seeing the world of women only from their perspective. So the way I've seen them, girls would be like, if they gel with someone, it would only take a week to call them as a soul sister or to call them as a best friend forever. So don't give so much of lenience to her. It's just been a week. It will take time to figure out who is who. No. And even the other girl was like, she is my soul sister. We were meant to be together, and they are not together now. No, they had a fight. Yeah, when we were in a relationship, they had a fight and it was ugly and they broke up. And that's the most common thing. Why the fuck girls tend to call the other girl as a BFF in just very few days? Why? I would be that woman and see that through my eyes. Who is my BFF and why are you my BFF? I would go and ask, why the fuck are you my BFF? Just because we have some common things? As a guy, we don't call. Even though Jesse is a close friend to me, I never mentioned that. You are my BFF, bro. You are my brother from another mother. It would take years to say that.
So, does that happen only in adolescent days, like in teens? I mean, making a BFF so soon, or does that happen even when you grow up? You know, like
even now,
late 20s. Do you guys made any new BFFs in this stage of life?
No, I haven't made any very much new. Like the best friends I had in my college, whatever the that kind of bondage I had, I couldn't find that much closeness right now. Now, even though I made friends and best friends, I don't get that connections, what I felt in college. Maybe that's the time we had a lot of time to spend together, or maybe the age. It's not just now best friends or BFF. Now it's all like godmothers, fairy godmothers, because all my friends who are getting married, they have a kids. So now I'm acting like a fairy godmothers to them.
Oh, damn. You're a mother to us and you're a mother to them too. Classic Shruti.
No, it's like, you know, like you're right from best friend stage. Now it's keep growing. Now you can't call forever. I'm like, she's my BFF forever. So things are getting changed. So that's what I wanted to say. Like, as your life is growing, new things keep coming up as a new responsibilities.
Yeah, that makes sense. I'm not a fairy godmother to anyone, but I would hope that I
me not either. Like, but I was being asked.
Did you have any fallout with your BFFs anytime? And I mean, you thought she's your BFF and you had a fallout, and now that woman is like gutter ki paidaish, something like that?
No, that has not happened with me. No.
Okay. I mean, it also depends upon the personalities, I guess. Someone who is very extrovert and being friendly, they would get a lot of BFFs. I know Shruti and everyone who is not extrovert at all. So I can understand Shruti's version. So I just wanted to know your side of the story. Yeah, I'm glad to know that you girls are not like that. Thank you. Will there be anything that you'll be missing as a opposite gender? I mean, since you're a guy now, man, and no, I'd be missing these things. So are there any things like that?
Yes, I would miss everything, I feel.
I mean, everything? Really? Is that
getting seat in a bus?
Oh, yeah.
That's something I have in my mind. Actually, if I change, I want to go to a public transport bus or something. I want to make a person who's sitting in a lady's seat, make him stand
get
up.
Get the fuck out.
I want to know how that feels,
Yeah. If I, I was saying, if I was a guy, okay, so you were, I was about
you're involved too much.
If I was a woman, as a guy, as I mentioned before, I would miss that physical freedom that I have. Everything, it's like you've been from a predator to a prey.
Yeah.
Both wrong words to use, but still, that's the reality. Yeah.
Being a guy in this world has a lot of
privileges.
Benefits. Being a girl actually have some, some kind of smaller benefits or something. Like we just mentioned, them having seeds and stuff. The guys paying bills like that, small benefits and stuff. But actually being a guy is a lot more easier in this world, You can't
That's
be a girl.
How it's been designed, seeds.
You can be a guy and sit on a rock somewhere on a cliff and you can just fall back and you can lie there for some time. Being a girl, you can't do that.
So this is, as Jesse said, he would go in a public bus and make them get up, right? I would never get into a public bus because in my experience, the way I talk to my friends, every girl, every friend of mine, every woman maybe, has been groped in some point or the other. Even if they sit in the bus, some guy is intentionally making his moves to touch certain parts of me. That's what they say. That's the worst feeling. Without your consent and shit like that, when that happens, that's scary. And I can't imagine as a woman, I can experience that. I can tolerate that shit on a regular basis. And also there's this, as a freedom, I can't even sit the way I want to. close your legs, don't bend, wear something, cover yourself up, don't shake your legs. What's that? I mean, oh my God. Whoa. That's actually, I heard this example and I didn't know. I didn't know this. I didn't even think about this. I heard this in a podcast. Okay. So she said, as guys, you don't have to think twice to go get some food, to go get some groceries, or to have a home delivery. You know, as a girl, we need to think twice, even to go outside. I have to change my clothes. Even if it's right beside my house, I have to change my clothes. And even if I'm getting a food order to my home, I have to be conscious that I'm what I'm wearing. As a guy, even if I'm in my shorts and boxers, I won't mind to open the door and take the stuff and go. Even it's a t-shirt and a shorts, I can walk to different states, not just the groceries. So I didn't think that way, and that's very sad, man. Oh my God, that's actually sad. So okay, since we got very serious with this, let's introduce some fun into it. If I'm a woman, I'll be fucking scared of waxing, bro. The pain, yeah, that a woman have to go through just to be accepted and to look good. Oh, exactly. My God. And you know, when I was with my girlfriend, she bought this charcoal face mask or something like that. So she applied it to me and let it rest. And after 10 minutes, she was just taking that out. And it got stuck in my, you know, eyebrows and there to my mustache here. So while she was taking it, she just took some, just like 1 inch. And I was like, what? There was tears in my eyes, you know. And she was like, on a scale of 1 to 10, the pain that you have is -5 when compared to waxing. And I was like, oh, applied some water and made it dilute, and then I took it out. That's not the way, she said. But yeah, I couldn't take that pain, man. And waxing, dude, how the fuck you guys do that? It looks painful, you know, applying that hot painful thing and just ripping it out of your skin. Oh, and I've feeling seen, painfully, and I've seen, yeah, and I've seen women, they would be like, something like that. I just yelled, what the fuck? Just for the charcoal mask. And you guys have this threshold for pain or what?
Maybe it's by years of doing it, you get that kind of numbness, or you are born to pain that bear that pain. Yeah, because I mean, you do it for a very long time. Maybe for the first time, even every girl or every woman feels the same pain when they're doing it for the first time. But eventually they try to do it a monthly basis or bi-monthly. So you tend to bear the pain and just keep going on.
Sure, oh, but my God.
To other people is just self-care, I would say. I mean, like, you do the things with so much pain just for yourself, not for someone's acceptance. You wouldn't take that much pain.
I mean, why? Why? Even for yourself, why are you taking that pain, man? I said, when I experienced that, mm-hmm, I made my girlfriend not to go for waxing. No, you don't go. You shouldn't go. Be what you are. I love you the way you are. I said that, but she is into that fashion designing and stuff like that. You will be judged so easily in a fashion industry if you're not maintaining those looks. So she said, I have to. Oh my God. I felt very sorry. And I'm sorry for women, for all the women in the world to go through this pain. And yeah, why do you think that the hair is not beautiful or something like that, which is very natural?
That's actually a society put up thing, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's all made up thing. See, I was like, see, even I don't have to prove myself, or I don't need anyone's acceptance. I had this thing, see. Right, just now I told, to look beautiful, I'm doing this. But no one said removing your hair will make you look beautiful. No one's said like a straight thing like that. But this kind of these things are being told within the society that kept growing along with you in your life. You tend to do it without your what do you say, without thinking.
Yeah,
it's got a habit.
Yeah, it's just something like that. There's no practical reason, but you have this thing in your mind.
Okay.
Yeah, you, Vishaka, you were saying something.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I wanted to share two experiences related to this. Not sure if that will extend the topic way beyond. So first experience I had was when I was in 10th class. That time I did not start waxing. My cousin, she was in college, and she took me to a parlor, and she told that, okay, you, this is time that you should start getting waxing and everything. I was like, okay, I did not have any clue what the fuck is this waxing. I went to the parlor, and the parlor lady, she saw my legs, and she was like, no, don't do it. They are so beautiful. So there was hair, but it was very neat and it was very natural. It looked very natural, and on fair legs, the, she liked it. She said that it's looking very nice. Don't do it. So I told my cousin, no, I'm not doing it now. So beauty, when you say that what looks beautiful, it is, I think, in the eyes of the beholder who is seeing you. Because for my cousin, it was like, it was the right time that I started getting waxed. But for the parlor lady, she saw it very beautifully. She told me not to get it done. So I think beauty these days is what and how you want to define it. Few people are okay having body hair. Few people are not okay having body hair. So it's up to personal choice, everyone's personal choice. Second experience was, it's not only men who are, you know, judging women with body hair. It's also the women judging women by body hair.
Yeah.
So when I was, I think this is 2 years back. So I was, it was time for my waxing. I was delaying it because of some reasons. There was an event coming up, so I wanted to delay it. So I was roaming in my shorts. I was in my flat, and there was a flatmate. She told me, she saw my legs, and she told me, dude, it's time for you to get waxed. I had a very, very, very weird thought in my mind that, okay, it's a girl who is saying to a girl that, dude, it's time for you to get waxed. My boyfriend has no issues. I don't have any issues. So who are you to just come up to me and say that? So, you know, these things are there in everyone's mind. It's no gender specific. And yeah, this is something that I just wanted to share. Just put it out there.
Yeah. So if I turn into a woman, if women tend to accept themselves, you know how many industries would get closed?
Yeah, bro.
There won't be any makeup industries, fashion industries, or this beauty standard industries. I think it's the fucking tax you need to pay to stay in this world.
It's a $1 billion industry, right?
Yeah.
Man, actually, oh, you know, it's a pain in two ways. Yeah, both economically, the money you spend on these things and the pain you have to go through, not just waxing, you know, a lot of stuff. You need to keep your, you know, eyebrows in a shape. You need to get your eyebrows and hair, and you go to parlors, you get the haircut, you know. You don't even get the haircut for, you know, 1 inch or something. Get even less than 1 inch, you get it cut, and you pay like, what, 1,000 or 1,200.
And
I mean,
everything for what? You get married to an uncle ultimately.
Yeah, that's not another thing. But yeah, man, so much maintenance. That's one of the thing. You know, I'm great. You know, happy that I'm a man. You know, I don't have to deal with all this stuff. It's a pain actually to me.
Speaking about the grooming industry, these days, men grooming industry is also taking a jump.
Yeah.
There are different kinds of hair wax and beard oil and beard grooming things whatnot. So that's also taking a jump.
Yeah. Thanks to social media for setting the beauty standards. And of course, it will take time to reach everyone in India though. We don't care.
Thanks to KGF.
Yeah. So, as I said before, everything for what, to get married to an uncle. As a woman, I would be a little less stressed regarding my career. I mean, if I am not a passionate, goal-oriented woman, I'm just a normal girl who wants to chill out. If I want to be that, I'm less stressed about my career, you know. I'll get married to some NRI guy, you know, have kids, have fun. I'll be safe. I don't have to worry, maybe. Of course, there are other perspectives. What if that guy is an asshole, that guy is torturing you? But still, I'm talking just in the career perspective. But as a guy, you won't have that. Dude, you need to take responsibility. You need to make a good career. You need to find a woman and you need to maintain her if he doesn't want to be independent. So you need to. So that need to take responsibilities, man, you will not enjoy that. And that's why most of the men don't follow their passion, because of these tensions. So you, as a guy, you won't be enjoying that. But as a woman, I'll be like, you know, aha, life hona chahiye aisa. And
though he's not talking about everyone, yeah, this is
reality. As I said, I mean, if I am a normal guy, a girl who wants to chill out without any goal, and there are lots of women are. I'm taking too seriously as a woman, you know. And there are lots of us. That was I was saying. Okay. For example, my master's friend who is an architect, who is working right now, but she didn't get the H-1B picked. And it's not easy for the art students to get H-1B that easily in US. So what she is planning right now, I'll get married to some guy who already has that H-1B visa and I'll work. Still be in US, I'll do my job. No tension. She's like that. But as a guy, you won't be having that freedom if you want. So, yeah.
I'm saying, right, you know, only the women and children are loved unconditionally. But
Man is only loved until he provides.
Yeah, something.
Women and dogs are the only things that will be loved unconditionally. A man is only loved until he provides. That's actually true. Saying,
that's not something we are making it up.
It's actually a saying. Yeah, a saying. So yeah, that's actually, yeah, I agree with it.
That makes a lot of sense. You know, some might say, you know, some might, you know, do not accept it completely, but on some level, it is true. So it might not work in everyone's life. Some level, it is true.
As Vishaka said in the very beginning of the pod, that as a woman, 100 men will listen to you and will hope to give a fuck, you know. But for a guy, you won't. So that's what the quote concludes. So you will be loved or cared at some point or the other by someone out of love or out of, you know, that envy, something like that. But as a guy, you need to provide to be loved in a constant period of time. So as I'm talking a lot about as a woman, but if you guys turned into guys, you would experience violence. I think you will have fun with it, I guess. Yeah, violence in the sense, not just the fights, but even with the friends, you know, yeah, in school, you might have seen two boys will be standing and one guy would be hitting on his balls. Just for the sake of fun. Just for the sake of fun.
See, let's say, I mean...
That kind of a violence.
For example, yeah, the birthday bumps.
Birthday bumps. Have you seen, right? Pick him up and kick...
That's crazy.
Kick the shit out of him, man. Yeah. So, you will experience violence and sometimes you are forced to enjoy that violence.
You can get it out of you, you know, that depression. You can.
Yeah.
That's one thing you can do as a, you know, man. I don't call it a privilege, but yeah.
It's fun, actually. Yeah.
So would you do that, Shruti? If you were, you know, given a chance to become a man and if you had a chance to fight with someone, so.
See, I would like to involve here. You know, even men don't want to involve in fights. No one wants to involve in fights. He is just asking that if you get a chance, there's no avoiding it. Would you be scared or would you be enjoying the situation? What would you do?
Yeah, with the girl's mind and a man's body.
Yeah, you have a girl's mind though, still. Yeah.
Yeah.
maybe I wouldn't get into any fights. I would just try to avoid it. But if I want to think from a men's brain as well, but I just want to, since I was being given a day or a week chance being a man, so I'll try to have that experience and see how it's really get into a real man fight.
To see testosterone. Yeah, to experience the testosterone.
It's like watching all this boxing, WWF from school age. I just want to feel if I can really punch someone like that and feel that.
Yeah, this shows how old you are. It's not WWF, it's WWE now. WWF was when we were kids.
I watched when I was young, so that one. And also want to experience sitting on, you know, I have seen guys sitting on bikes, chilling with their friends on the roads. So I want to see how it really will feel. And not to tease anyone, just to sit on bikes like that randomly on some street and have some talk.
As a guy, I just want to give you an advice that, you know, don't get the nuts. Don't get kicked in the nuts. You will be dead, bro. Don't get kicked in the nuts. I know that waxing is painful.
Compare it with, you know, giving, you know, birth to someone. Yeah, let's keep it aside for some time. Just don't get kicked in the nuts. It's really painful. Don't,
you know,
it's,
like...
Oh my God, no way, bro. You know, waxing and no pregnancy, everything is painful, I know. But there are things which can make you experience how pregnancy pains feel like. You know, there are some YouTube videos too. But there are no machines to tell you how getting kicked in the nuts feels like.
And even there's other pain which woman feels is like getting your hair pulled, you know, that's the...
Oh, yeah.
She's getting excited.
I that's so much pain.
It's not exciting. It's not exciting. You know, I suggested, I was talking to my sister once during BTech, I guess. These were the times when I was learning some kickboxing and shit like that. So I was teaching what I learned from the boxing school. So I told her, Akka, when girls fight, why do you go for the hair? When they are going for the hair, they are leaving the whole body for you. No, you can kick in the, you know, punch in the face, kick in the ribs. You know, you're leaving the main parts. So I was, why are you going for the hair and pulling? What do you get from that? As an enemy, you need to injure him. So why are you leaving the whole body? So that's what I thought. I said, well, what do you get? I mean, why you go for hair? Why is that?
You get a lot of pain when someone pulls your hair.
Okay.
That's an easy trigger point as well. I don't know, like if my sister or some sibling tries to pull my hair, that's an easy trigger point. I get into a fight.
Oh my. Is that common for every woman or?
What about you, Vishaka? I mean, do you get triggered when someone pulls your hair?
Yeah, I think we are very emotionally connected to our hair. And if someone tries to touch it or someone is, you know, just playing around with it or pulling it or doing anything when not needed and not asked to. So at that time, we really get pissed.
Okay. We are only emotionally attached to it when we are losing it. Yeah.
Yeah, don't say, bro.
So, yeah, guy problems. Okay.
One thing, so another thing I would like to experience if I turn into a woman is the periods thing. I would like to experience how it feels like and maybe work on those days and feel how exactly, you know, it will be like. I mean, working under pressure and having another pain in your body is a whole different game, right? I mean, a different experience totally. So I would like to, I mean, if I...
PMS?
Yeah, sure.
PMS? Yeah. By waxing nahi ho raha para mujhse. No? Waxing nahi ho raha para mujhse. Aur ye PMS har month? I can't take it, bro.
Yeah,
and the fucking mood swings that I experienced with my girlfriends or my sister when they're in the PMS. Oh my God. That's a whole another story. I mean, why are you getting angry for a very small reason? And why are you getting emotional for a very small reason? I don't want to experience the pain, but I want to experience those mood swings, you know?
The worst part is, it's like for every month.
Yeah.
Not like a year. You don't get it once a year. For every month you get it, man.
So you need to go through this pain. Oh my God, that's very scary, bro.
Yeah. Yeah, to boys, yeah, that's scary actually. I mean,
yeah. Yeah. Experiencing it every month, no, I give up. Sorry.
Yeah, once a year, maybe, yeah.
Maybe, yeah.
Once a year,
yeah.
Can't take it, yeah.
So, yeah. And you, Vishaka, are you saying something? Yeah, what's up?
Yeah. So I mean, they say it out that in a corporate culture, in professional life, men and women are equal and they should be treated equally. But I don't think that that should be the way, because equality is, and everything is okay, but there should be few things. Like Zomato company has recently come out with periods leave. So whenever like in a month, if girl is going through that, then she can take those 5 days leave. So that is something, these kind of things need to come up in big MNCs and industries as well. That is when you can say that, yes, equality is there, not just by giving same pay scale and promotions and appraisals, but things like this also run in the background. So they should be taken care as well.
Yeah. EMS and mood swings, yeah. As I turn into a woman, the way we approach romance, the perspective will completely change. You know, for to begin with, I'll enjoy saying no to my partner as a woman. You know, and it's not easy too, I guess. As a, you know, the romance from a woman perspective is not easy, because as Monica from Friends famously said, there are 7 erogenous zones for women. And Chandler be like, there are 7? Okay. And for men, ek AAB ka video tha yaar. It was like a pun on sex education. So there were, a girl would be in a car like, bhai sahab, ye male orgasm kaha pahunch sakte? How can we reach the male orgasm? And the guy would be like, go straight and just sing. You will reach there. Just sing. I don't have to do anything. Yeah, just sing. And a guy comes and, bhai sahab, ye female orgasm kaha pahunch sakte? And the guy would be like, sahab, aap straight jao, right jao, left jao, circle maro, aur seedha jao, aur kutta rahega, aur wa usse right jao. Oh my God. So, the thing that the romance from a woman's side is very difficult. As the world statistics say, 70% of the men's world failed to make the woman feel pleasure. Right now, there's all the sex education and stuff, but previously, there are no such things, right? So, the perspective is changed completely, and I would enjoy the privilege of saying no. Koi bhi aake time bhi puchega na, I'll be like, no.
I've done that, you know. I've done that.
Why?
I don't know. Privilege.
Okay. Yeah, man. How will you tackle the casual sexism with the privilege that you have as a guy?
Give some examples.
You go out. You are a guy now, so you can't be groped easily. Yeah, and for example, I've seen this when Avengers movie cast go for promotions, they ask about acting and shit for the male actors, and for the female actors, the questions will be, were you on your diet to be in shape? What were you wearing? Who were you wearing? Something like that. No, this is this. And they don't even think about it. This is casual sexism towards the woman. And you are a guy now. So what would you do? I asked one of my colleagues this, and she said, as a guy now, I would go punch everyone who tries to grope, and know, punch everyone who asked such type of questions. And I just experienced the strength and the testosterone that I have. That was actually nice. Do you guys have any same thoughts like that?
What I would do is I would go to the same places as a girl where I would go. And I would see how different I would be feeling being a man in the same place.
Oh,
maybe
yeah.
I'll go to the same coffee shop. I'll see how they're going to... I can see from a girl's perspective how they're treating me and a man differently. But I want to just try to... No, it's hard to say, like, think in their own shoes, something like that. But I just wanted to feel being a man, how I'm being treated over there and compare myself.
Yeah.
In the same places. I wouldn't try something new and get a different experience. Yeah. I'll try the same place where I go as a woman and see.
Yeah, that's actually good, you know, comparison.
It's scary for a woman to trust someone, especially from the opposite gender, in terms of relationships. You know, I'd be scared. What if, you know, he's using me? What if I'm just a time pass, something like that? The far worst thing would be, what if I get pregnant? Oh my God. Isme do baat hai. First thing is getting pregnant before marriage is very a taboo thing in the society. And the other thing is, the childbirth is very painful. Mujhse vaccine nahi ho pa raha hai. I can't take PMS. And childbirth is the worst thing that you have to experience. And I listen to the dialogues, you know. Jab pehli baar ek bachcha maa ko pulata hai, wo hasi, wo khushi, ghanta hasi and khushi. Man, I don't want that. I don't want to experience that pain. I don't want to experience childbirth. I think I won't be having a partner if I turn into a woman. Maybe some fuck buddies, maybe. But I won't be having a partner and have childbirth and something like that. Maybe that makes me sound like a bitch or something. But yeah, a bitch would be very happy in this men's world. I mean, in the world right now. Then very good woman suffers a lot, I guess. Or maybe it's the man's brain that is speaking right now.
He's the man's brain that is speaking right now.
Yeah.
So, like, being a brother or husband or a boyfriend to a girl, like a sister or a wife. So, yeah. you might be feeling something that is, you might not be feeling good or the behavior of a girl at some certain point of time. So, if you think that if I was a girl, I would do the right thing. Like maybe take a situation where a brother and sister are fighting and you would say, as a girl, you need to do like this, but your sister is trying to be against your words or trying to do something different. Mm-hmm. Like if you were in the same situation, you're being made into a girl and your sister is into a brother, would you react the way how would you think as a man, or you would think like your sister and act?
సో ఇప్పుడు ఏమడుగుతున్నావు నువ్వు? ఒక సిచ్యువేషన్లో అమ్మాయిని నువ్వు మీ చెల్లిని అయితే వద్దంటున్నావు, నువ్వే రేపు అమ్మాయి అయితే అదే సిచ్యువేషన్ లో నువ్వేం చేస్తావునా?
యా
స్టిల్ హావ్ ద మ్యాన్స్ బ్రెయిన్ రైట్
బట్ స్టిల్ వి
ఆర్ ఐ మీన్ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ద
సిచ్యువేషన్
ఇట్స్ యా ఐ మీన్ ఇట్స్ అబౌట్ యు నో ద ఫ్రీడమ్ ఆఫ్ ద గర్ల్ డెఫినెట్లీ విల్ దెన్ నో ఐ మీన్ హౌ షీ వుడ్ హావ్ ఫెల్ట్ యు నో on the other side. I mean, we changed our positions, right?
It's a, you know, every, if a guy who has a sister, he can experience this without the sex change or something, you know. If, for example, I have a sister, so when I am with my partner, and if I am trying to kiss, or we are in a intimate situation, I just want to be in that moment. I just want to experience that. But if I think the same way, if my sister or someone who I know in the same situation, I might not agree with it. Because, you know, because I know how a man thinks. How a woman thinks. And women, not all, I'm not saying about all the women though. But maybe women would be thinking like, this is the guy. He is the man and I love him. But man would be like, I want to be in this moment, for this moment. You are, I want to be with you. I love you. And after the moment, I don't know whether he will be in the same shoes while he's in the moment or not. So you get me? So One of the most irritating questions that men experience is, where is this going? Where is this going? I don't know where my life is going. I just want to experience in the moment, man. We'll see, we'll go with the flow. That's what all the men want to say. But everyone would be like, okay, what do I have to say now? No, and then they overcommit and they can't feel that commitment. So I think we are drifting away from the question. So we are all dancing in the hypocrisies. You know, I will do some shit, but I don't want my sister to do the same shit.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's how the world is running. Since I turned into a girl and I have a brother who is restricting me from doing certain shit, I don't know whether I'll take him seriously. And since I have the man's brain, I won't be in that situation. If I have the woman's brain, I'm a complete woman, then I don't know whether I'll be taking him seriously, because I'm 28, right? I can take my own decisions. That's the way I think. So, yeah.
Yeah, that's a good question, actually. I mean, I don't know what I would do, I mean, if I am in such situation. I mean, exchanging positions. The way, I mean, the brother feels for her sister and the sister, you know, wants to live her own life. Those things, you know, can complicate the relationship. The sister, the brother wants to protect the sister and he wants her sister to be in some way, I mean, in some cultured manner. It's not cultured manner. You know, he wants her to be in some kind. But the sister wants to live her own life. Now we have changed the characters. Yeah, that's a good question, actually. I can't think, I mean, how that works out.
There's a saying, you know, a girl asks his brother that, when you can roam with girls, why can't I roam with boys? And the brother responds, because you know what love is, but I know what men are. So that's how it is.
Yeah, that's one thing I had in mind. If I become woman, that I know the men, how the men around me are. Yeah, I can be more careful in the sense.
Since I have the man's brain and a woman's body, I'll perfectly know what would be his intentions are.
Yeah, exactly.
And I would hit the bullseye. Right. And I would hit the bullseye with everything that he says.
Exactly. I mean, whatever the word it is, anything the other guy says, you can get it instantly. Okay, this is what he means.
Yeah.
Yeah. that would be good, actually.
I would enjoy that privilege and
Definitely. Should we discuss something on the breakup, recovering from breakup strategy of men and women? They are very different. Sure.
Why not?
So how do men recover from any relationship breakups? And
see, it's, you hear from everyone and anyone how to recover from breakup. You know, someone will say drink, and someone has this scientific strategy that the longer the relationship, half of the time is what it takes to get out of the breakup. If it's 10 years of a relationship, it takes 5 years of time to get out of it. It's what they say. It's what they say. I don't know whether it's proved or not. But you need to realize the fact that there will be always a part of them in you. No matter what you do, there will always be a part in you. You need to be okay with that fact. And what I do is I get busy. If you are not doing anything, you would be in those thoughts. You would be in that shit. You won't be who you were if you are idle and doing nothing. Of course, it's okay to be in pain for a certain period of time. But as a man, you don't have that emotional freedom. You can't go and express. And I want to say this, but everyone has to go to a therapist or something like that if he has this inconvenience expressing emotionally, which is, men think that it's not a manly thing to do, but everyone has to go through it if they need it. It's far better than going into depression, drinking and smoking and shit like that. So to get out of it, I would, I read something, I think it's from the Jim Carrey said it, you know, to get out of a depression or to get out of a breakup, you need to give to the body the ability to fight it. You know, just by sitting, you're not fighting it. You are just embracing it. So in order to fight it, go work out, stay healthy, eat healthy, hang out with friends, stay happy places, stay with the happy places and get busy. This is how you fight everything. That's what he says, because he has been through that. He's been through worse though. Some friend of him died saying that he was the sole responsible for her depression, and she died. And he went to a depression after that. So that's how he said. So for everyone who went through a breakup, I would suggest this. Go work out, get sweat, and eat healthy. That's very important. Don't eat outside food. And of course, cooking helps like a therapy session, you know, for most of us. When I have a bad day, I'll just go get some favorite food of mine and I cook myself and I eat. So eat healthy, work out, get busy. So that's how it would be to get out of a breakup in a healthy way. But it would be very long to get out of it. And for some, it would be like, if you can get another woman. Yeah, I think I came into this perspective that a girl, I'm not generalizing it. A girl can get a guy easily if she wants to, because men are easily available, you know, and it's not a complaint. This is how it works. If the it's on the girl whether she chose to go out and date some other guys, and that's how it is, right? Always ek ladki ek ladke ke peecha nahi karegi na, ek ladka ek ladki ke peeche hi karegi. There are instances where the girl goes around a boy though, but I'm talking about the proportion, if 80-20, something like that. So men, a woman can get a guy after a breakup if she wants to easily. And for a guy, it won't be that easy. You know, you need mehnat karna padega tu ek ladki ko patane ke liye. So, and when he's in depression, he can't make that efforts to impress someone else. So that's why it takes very long for the guys to get out of it. I know. Yeah, I have friends who went to depression, man, because of breakup, which changed their life. They were too deep into it. And there are certain girls like this, who can't emotionally express too. So they went into depression. They felt far worse. And
my
words would be hurting for them, because they experienced so much shit. And I'm saying that women can find a guy easily. These words hurt them, but their experience is way more different. I'm just taking this on a whole perspective on what the proportion would be. Yeah. Don't get into drinking and smoking like the Devdas. Those are for glory and shit like that. And they only look, pain looks good on camera. For a good story, pain is a very good thing. So don't idealize that. No. So what, how woman, if I turn into a woman and I had a breakup, how can I come out of a breakup?
Yeah, you go find another guy.
But I don't know. I want to be in a true relationship, and I don't know whether he's an asshole or he's a true guy or he's using me. I need a woman brain on this. What's your take on breakups and finding another guy? What would you do? Everyone has a breakup. So, as in the film say, you go running, fall onto the bed, upside down, and cry until the pillow gets wet. And what would you do next? These are the rules, right? Okay, I was just joking. So, if the breakup happened, what's going through?
Crying will make you feel lighter. Like, you're just pushing out all the pain within you.
Yeah, that's actually a good point. Yeah.
Crying maybe a couple times, that's healthy, that's good. But like I won't like to generalize, because everyone's breakup journey and everyone's recovery from breakup is different. Crying a couple times is okay. Feeling sad, upset, that's healthy. It's not abnormal. But not being able to focus on the real things which are there in your life because of the sadness and because of upset mood and everything, that is wrong according to me. So because you have to consider the other things which are there in life. Your family is there, your friends are there, you yourself are there, and you have to make sure that you are giving yourself the best life that you deserve. So just because you went through a breakup and because that has happened. You cannot change it. And I don't think you should try to change it also. You should not try to go back to the person who has already broken your heart once. So the things which are going to come in the future, you have to focus on those. The present which is there with you, you have to focus on that. And like Ajay said, that try being healthy, try being focused on something else, because that really helps. The whatever energy, so when you are feeling upset, when you are sad, there is an energy which is in you. So you have to make sure that you are putting that energy in a positive direction, rather than that energy is taking you along in a negative direction. You have to push that energy in a positive direction. Only then I think a person can recover from a breakup as early as possible. But yeah. Yes, like I said, everyone has their different ways of coming out of it. A few like to take their own time and travel, and they come out of it like that. Few work out like hell, and they get summer bodies, and they get such great bodies that now their exes are
jealous of
like,
them. Yeah.
Oh my god, why? What did I do?
Yeah.
So yeah, everyone has a different, and few try pursue their passion, and they come out stronger. So everyone has a different way.
Yeah. As a suggestion, there's this Amazon Prime video 1.5 hour thing of Zakir Khan, which says Huxley Single. I think watch that. It would be very for guys. Okay, it would be very comforting. Yeah, that would help.
Autobiography.
Yeah, breakup. No, you can't. As we mentioned before, guys can't afford pain for a long time because of the responsibilities that he have to take on, and to the and the world that he has to take upon. Even to get married and to maintain the people that he have to. So you can't afford that. It's better to focus on you and make money and stay happy. You want me to
go to a traffic? I will make a mess in a road or something. And if a traffic person comes, I'll just say, मैं छोटी बच्ची हूँ, please excuse me for this time. And if he excuses me for me being a girl, I'll kill him on the road.
मैं ladies हूँ.
That actually works everywhere. It works in school, it works in colleges, it works everywhere, almost everywhere.
Yeah. And I forgot to mention, during our BTech, so some CSE boys were giving warning to one of our friend. So he was like, and I was just observing from a long shot. So he was like, I will see how you will go home today, how you will get out of the college today. And he was warning like that. And she was very scared, man. And I know that that guy won't be doing anything, but he just want to scare, because I can see the men's perspective, right? He just wants to scare her. And he said that, and she was like, her shields were up for the entire time until she went to her home. Just a small line can disturb you like hell. Uska to chod. The last month I was traveling to Kansas, and my flight was at morning 5:30. So I have to leave at 3:30 in the morning. So I have a car, so I have to Uber. And the Uber guy came, and for many reasons, he was not, pleasant. He was not a pleasant guy. So the car was also not that great. It was smelling like weed or something. But he was not on the weed. But if you smoke weed, it will stay for a longer time in that car. So that car came, and I don't have a choice. You won't be having too many cars at that time. So I went on, and he didn't take the normal route that he have to take to go for the airport. He just turned to go through a shortcut, and it was so dark, and there was no street lights, and it's just the car and the road that you can see with this car light. As a guy, I was scared. I was like, okay, if something goes wrong, what do I have to do? The way I was thinking at that time was that way. Okay, kya karna hai abhi? And he took me to the airport. Nothing else, nothing much happened, you know. But as a guy, I was scared. Think that if you were in an auto in India and you are alone and you are a girl, even though that guy was good, I would be so scared, man. You know. So yeah, since now India is known to be not safe for women in the world of where are we ranking in the women's safety? First?
No, I thought like maybe the most dangerous country for women to live in. We top there.
Yeah, we'll be somewhere in the top
10. I thought we will be in the top 10. Yeah, maybe after ISIS countries and stuff like that. Maybe in fifth country or something like that. So yeah, that would be scary. Oh my God, I don't want to be in that shoes.
So yeah, whenever I Uber or anything, it can be any sedan or it can be Prime, any car. But I always ask the guy to put the window panes down. There's AC running, there's everything is good, but I always ask him to have the window panes down for my so I have an escape route at least.
Yeah, yeah.
Even if he's doing the child lock and everything, I have an escape route, and I always try to have an auto, because you can at least jump out of an auto. You cannot jump out of a car. So yeah.
Oh my. No, it's it feels like to be a prey in the world of predators. Even though the predator doesn't have anything against you, but still.
See, being a girl, I mean, when you're a girl, you have to be on a constant alert. You know,
yeah.
All of your senses should be working 24/7. Mm. Doesn't matter if you're sleeping or not.
Yeah.
That's the one thing I, you know, being a guy, I, you know, I'm happy about. I don't have to be like that. I can sleep. I mean, I can, you know, relax at any moment of time, you know, any day. But if you are a girl, you can't do it. You have to be alert all the time.
Yeah, maybe most of the girls, if they are turned into guy, they go to the guy who groped or molested her in the past and make him bleed, I guess. That's what they do.
Yeah. I have one final question.
Yes.
Oh, sorry, Vishaka.
No. So, go ahead. Yeah.
So once you're back to normal, I know everyone has respect towards opposite gender. So once you're back to normal, do you think your respect would increase more, and you would feel everything good for the other person?
You don't even have to experience. You just have to give it a thought, just to see that what they go through. But if you experience of course the respect goes much. As I said before, I had this charcoal face mask and I felt the pain, and I said to my girlfriend that don't ever get waxed. I don't want you to feel this pain again. I take the way you are. So maybe I would do that if I experience everything and that a girl can experience. Maybe I won't have any kids. I won't let her go through the pain. I would have an increased respect.
Getting a thought will have an impact on your life longer. Do you think getting a thought for 5 minutes will give you a huge impact on your life for a longer time? Or is just for that?
Depends upon the thought. Depends upon the thought.
Depends on the situation. I mean, if we change to the opposite gender and the things happen in that period of time, decides how much impact or how long the change stays with us. When we change genders and we see the pain the opposite gender is going through, for sure, everyone remembers how it felt, and they see it with their perception. Next time they change back to their own genders, the perception remains, right? I mean, when something is happening, they'll just relate to it. I mean, this thing happened to me last time. How I felt when I was a girl. Now the girl is in front of me. She must be going through the same. And that person might react, accordingly. I think, yeah, it will stay for a long time, in my opinion.
Very long time. And given that experiences are way powerful, but thoughts are the things which change the world. No, you can't experience everything, even if you want to. You know, thoughts are powerful. You know, communism is a thought. The guy who created communism, like Karl Marx and Engels, they never implemented communism, but it changed the world. Capitalism is a thought, but it was implemented by someone else. So, and as in the last pod, we said Friedrich Nietzsche's philosophy is a thought. As a man, you need to be a Superman. But Hitler took it in a different way and he took over the world. So thoughts are never implemented by the guy who said that. But the guys who implemented it made it powerful. So even though we don't experience what the girl is experiencing, those thoughts of what she can go through, what she has been through, and when you talk to them, and I've talked to so many, man. I talked to women who were molested. I talked to a prostitute. Yeah. So, yeah, I've been there. I've talked to them and their life experiences were very different. I mean, experience, I meant to say, you know, their perspective is different, how they view it. The girl who got molested hates men. She's more like a tomboy maybe now. She hates men to the core. Okay. We can't judge them though. But their experiences made them to turn into a different way. So the experiences and thoughts is a very deep topic if we have to go through. I think Sadhguru has to say a lot on this because she is into books. I'm just saying.
Yeah, so this is a good topic for pod actually. Thoughts or experiences, which one you think have created a difference in your life? So
yeah,
good one.
So, yeah. So, మొత్తానికి కన్క్లూజన్ లో ఏంటంటే అబ్బాయిలకి బాగా ప్రివిలేజెస్ ఎక్కువ ఉన్నాయి. మెన్ హ్యావ్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ప్రివిలేజెస్ వెదర్ యూ యాక్సెప్ట్ ఇట్ ఆర్ నాట్ బట్ ఇట్స్ టఫర్ ఉమెన్ మ్యాన్ అవుట్ సైడ్ దేర్ ఆర్ సర్టన్ ప్రివిలేజెస్ టు ఉమెన్ అండ్ మెన్ దో బట్ మెన్ హ్యావ్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ప్రివిలేజెస్ వెన్ కంపేర్ టు ఉమెన్ అండ్ ఐ హోప్ దోస్ థింగ్స్ విల్ చేంజ్ అఫ్ కోర్స్ బయోలాజికల్ థింగ్స్ వోంట్ చేంజ్ దో బట్ యునో that freedom, that emotional freedom and the physical freedom, everyone should have the same. Yeah, so that's it for this week's podcast, guys. We'll get back to you again soon. Keep listening to Bekar Muchetlu. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Bye. And everyone say bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
వా శృతి నువ్వు దేవుడా బాయ్ చెప్పడానికి కూడా ఎంత ఆలోచిస్తావంటే తల్లి. Thank you.